Hey guys, today I'm going to be talking about how you can take notes on your iPad, so keep watching. Start off by talking about the benefits of taking iPad notes and the materials you will need. The biggest benefit is that you don't have to carry around notebooks anymore, you just have an iPad to take notes with. In terms of materials, I like to use the 11.4-inch iPad, and I also have the second generation Apple Pen. And you can see in the background all the apps that I use. I also have a matte protector sheet that I got from Amazon, and the app that I use for note taking is GoodNotes. I'm going to be focusing a lot on GoodNotes because that's what I mainly use. I love using GoodNotes because of the various folders and notebooks that you can use to take notes. You can see here how there is a variety of different notebooks and different types of papers that you can use for your notes. Personally, I will always pick the black squared paper, or I will go with the white squared paper or dotted paper, and I like to have no cover, or I like to use the brown cover that comes with it. And you can see here how you can even use it for planning and things like that. GoodNotes is a paid app, so I'm going to be explaining what you can do without GoodNotes. I recommend using the Notes app that you can find on your iPad, and it should come with it. I like to typically pair my keyboard and my mouse with my iPad so that I can just work and type out things in the Notes app. If you're looking into apps that you don't really want to pay for, the Notes app that comes with the iPad is great. You can also use your Apple Pen to write in your notes in the Notes app. Now I'm going to move on to the actual note-taking process. Like I stated before, I always like to go with the black squared paper. And there are a couple of different pens that you can use in GoodNotes. The first pen is the fountain pen, which is basically like a calligraphy pen but has a more lighter stroke. I like to use this sometimes if I want to go in with a calligraphy header. The second pen is the ball pen, which is what I use almost half of the time. This is just a normal writing pen and I like to use it for all my text. The last one is a brush pen, which you can use for calligraphy. I'm not a big fan of it because you don't really have a lot of control with the brush pen, but if you really like the brush pen, you can go ahead and use that. A really cool part about the app is that there are different size brushes that you can use, and you can even control what sizes that you want. The lowest one is what I use for most of my writing. I use the second largest one for my titles, and I don't really use the third one a lot, but I might use it for titles. There's also a variety of colors that you can use on GoodNotes, and you can change up the color whenever you want. And you can always use the eraser to erase anything if you're not really happy with it. There is also a highlighting feature that you can use if you're reading anything for school. You can import that to GoodNotes and you can highlight the text too, which I think is pretty cool. Next are some of my favorite features. So you can also draw different shapes and it'll kind of auto-correct it for you, which is really helpful if you're in math class or geometry and you're trying to draw in perfect diagrams to understand the material. I think this is also one of the biggest benefits of using your iPad or GoodNotes. What you can do is you can move your text wherever you want. When you're writing written notes, that's not really an option. You can do that with the iPad. What I also love about GoodNotes is that it lets you import in images so you can add in your diagrams to your notes. And obviously, if you're presenting anything, you can use the little mouse to present. I'm gonna stop talking about the features and go on to how I actually take notes. What I like to do for the title is I like to use the second brush and just write in my title with a white or a colored font. And I like to add in little doodles here and there to make it look more better. So as you can see, I am underlining the whole word, and you can use the shape thing to make it look more straight. And then I'm adding in little doodles using my green pen. If I'm feeling super fancy, then I'll go ahead and with a calligraphy title, and I like to use the Procreate app to do that, and I'll just import that as an image into my notes. You can see over here that I'm just importing that image. And the rest of it is pretty self-explanatory. I will just use arrows or bullet points to write out the words. And typically what I'll do is for vocabulary words, I like to use different colors to make it stand out, as you can see over here. And you can see here how I'm sort of applying that same thing and using a different color for a different vocab word. So that's just a short tutorial on how I take iPad notes, and that's it for the video. Thank you.